Yes. I think I would like to begin with highlighting one point, and that is we need to realize that 30 or 40 years ago, education, especially when we talk about the content, the curriculum, was built upon social sciences like anthropology, sociology, I mean, to design the content of what is to be delivered at school. But later on, especially nowadays, because we have the technology to understand better about learning process, and because of that, what actually happened in a student when learning is taking place, is now being understood more and more. So that is one of the reasons why education is shifting from teaching to learning. Previously, when we were thinking about improving the quality of education at schools, we always think about improving the way teachers are teaching. But now we are supposed to move towards a better aspect of the same concern, and that is to improve teachers' understanding about how people learn, because we know better now about learning. And that is where pedagogy should be touched. For example, if I refer to what my own children experienced during this our Finnish version of MCO here in Finland, I realized that one of the major challenges they faced was when teachers introduce new topics, because we know from how knowledge is built upon, we are always being advised as teachers to activate students' prior knowledge. We need to make the connection between past knowledge, something that students already know, with the new things that need to be introduced in the classroom. So without having teachers face to face, my children from the age of 10 up to 18 had almost a similar challenge, because when I discussed with them, that is what they raised up. They felt very difficult to deal with this aspect. So when this aspect requires more research on it, because I would love to read maybe in 1 year time what will be the assessment of researchers on the experience students have. But at least at this stage, I would say that activating having a better metacognitive strategy in handling teaching and learning session online would be something very useful for teachers to take into account. One thing that been highlighted maybe by Dr. Tazli or Mei as well just now, COVID-19 experience made teachers aware better about the students' point of view. We have been talking about this for a very long time. Even before COVID-19, that is how a teacher should behave. When you plan something, you should always remember about the student's point of view. And that is why even in Finland, best students are not necessarily the best candidates to become good teachers. So a teacher education system have their own way to select students to become teachers, because sometimes teachers who struggle when they were students themselves have more empathy towards understanding the student point of view. So now, when students disappeared, missing in action, it should already tell us something. It means that before COVID-19, the relationship between students and their learning, students with schooling, student with classroom, student with even the teachers, were not that strong. But we control everything with our space, the way we shape the space, meaning that we have classroom with all these walls, because the history of walls for schools is meant to control a bunch of children so that they will focus on this thing that teachers are deliver. And that is one of the reason why, again, I am very sorry for keeping mention about Finland, because because I am in Finland, some people maybe got exhausted, eye bleeding, ear bleeding listening to this word. But in Finland, in the past maybe around 10 years, they utilize what we know as open learning space, where there is no wall anymore. Because if the learning is meaningful enough, if the session is meaningful enough, you don't need wall. You have a group of students, 30 students in one session, and you have another group of 30 students in a different group, maybe around 10 to 15 meters away. You don't have a wall to separate, but students were not really distracted because they were engaged with this learning. So when students do not participate in our teaching session, of course, there are many other things that we need to take into account, but we as teachers have to rethink about how the learning activities are designed. Maybe they are poorly designed and not meaningful enough, as simple as having a person walk behind you that is already distracting for students to, you know, to look at that guy because they are not fully engaged. So that is why, going back to the original question that you asked just now, it is very important for the teachers nowadays to understand better how people learn, make use of learning sciences in our school, in Khalifah Model School primary and secondary. Somehow, I don't make it compulsory, but I enforce the teacher to read the book, How People Learn. And it is freely to download because a good teacher is a teacher who understands how children learn, how people learn. So you improve your teaching by knowing better how children are learning and not simply improving the way we teach. Because when we teach, that does not mean learning is happening in the classroom, because teaching and learning are two separate things. You can teach, but you cannot ensure that learning is taking place. Learning will only happen when you focus on learning itself. So make use of learning sciences and all the new information we have in the past 20 or 30 years to improve this aspect of our education. Yeah.